Hello everybody, today I, Manish Kumar Verma, is making this video regarding the subject known as auditing. Usually the subject called auditing has been taught in BCom third year and last year semesters. So in this video I am going to cover a very important chapter which name is New Trends in Auditing. Friends, New Trends in Auditing is a kind of chapter which contains only just three topics, that is cost audit, management audit and tax audit. So I have been making this video regarding this chapter, which is separated in three parts. First part is cost audit, second is management audit, and third part is tax audit. So in this video I am going to talk you about cost audit, that what does the cost audit means. First of all, we would like to take a note on, you should note each and every kind of things which has been spoken by me in this video. So first of all, I am going to start with cost audit. In cost audit, the first point it is written that definitions should be written according to the some prominent people, which is given by the some prominent people. So first of all, if I give you a kind of a glimpse of cost audit, then what does the cost audit means? Friends, all the firms marketing cost, all the firms making cost, all the firms making cost to decide their selling price. Okay, all the firms are analyzing the cost of their everything, like marketing cost and all other cost is been analyzed by each and every kind of firm to decide their selling price. So whether the cost is been which is analyzed by those, whether they are in correct form or not, but it is not necessary to do the cost audit to check the whether they have the things which they have analyzed is correct or not. They used to do cost audit, but it is not necessary to do the cost audit for any kind of firm. Some manufacturing industries have to give their information to central government as well, that what is the cost they are procuring, and sometimes the central government can give order to any manufacturing concern to do the cost audit for their respective firm, or central government can also demand for public utility, like the industry which are using or are running their business in the form of public utility, can we gain any kind of order from central government that they have to do cost audit, like related to electricity, water, gas, because there the complaint regarding these kind of things is strictly goes to the government. So government can order to do the cost audit. Now I am going to tell you about the definitions of the cost audit. Friends, cost audit's definitions should be known by some prominent, you can say prominent speaker. Like first is here, according to Smith and Bay, he has said that the detailed checking of the costing system, techniques and accounts to verify their correctness and to ensure adherence to the objective of cost accountancy. I repeat, the detailed checking of the costing system, techniques and accounts to verify their correctness and to ensure adherence to the objective of cost accountancy. This is the definition which is given by Smith and Bay. Next is according to ICWA London. The definition which is given by ICWA London is kind of a gold mine for us. The definition which is given by ICWA London is like that. Cost audit can be defined as verification of the correctness of cost account in adherence to the cost accounting principles, plans and procedures. Okay, this is the perfect definition for cost audit as far as the Smith and the Bay and ICWA London is being concerned. Now I would like to tell you about the objective of cost audit. Objective of cost audit has been categorized into the two forms. First is objects of cost audit from institution's point of view, and objects of cost accounting from government point of view. If we talk about the object of cost audit from institution's point of view, there are 9 points. First of all, I would like to tell you what does this means, like material cost, variable cost, total cost, all work done with efficiency or not. These kind of cost is being accumulated by the entrepreneur in a correct way or not, whether the work done in with full efficiency or not, wastage is been done or not, how much idle hour is there or it is there or not. Manufacturing concern should do cost audit to know this kind of things. So the objective of cost audit, as far as the objects of cost audit from institution's point of view has been concerned, there are total 10 points. I am going to speak 10 points in front of you. You just make notes of it. 9 points, sorry. First is to know about total cost and cost per unit first. Second, use of material, labor and capital with efficiency. Second point. Third, to know accuracy of the cost account. Fourth, to give advice to manager about cost planning. Fifth, to obey Government Act and institution. Government Act instructions. It is fifth point. Sixth, to know about fraud and misappropriation in cost account. Seventh, analysis of cost expenditure. Analysis of cost expenditure. Eighth, adequacy of cost account. And ninth, proper valuations of work in progress and closing stock. These are the objects of cost audit from institution's point of view. And if I talk about objects of cost accounting from government point of view, it's not accounting, it's audit. Object of cost audit from government point of view, there are total 7 points. Look, government also do cost audit. Like they see tax avoidance hai ya nahi, exploitation is not happening to the industry, exploitation is not happening to the customer, whether industries are safe or not to work further, whether industry is in position to run their business in future. If they are not able to run their business in future, then what kind of subsidy should be provided by the government? So government look after these kind of things so that in future they could get their own business concern. In this, the first is protections to industry. Second, possibility of employment. Third, to know about unproductive work. Fourth, safety of consumer interest. Fifth, safety of public interest. Sixth, safety from tax evasion. And seventh, alternative of resources. These are the object of cost audit. Now comes the types of cost audit. Under this, the first type is internal cost audit, which means it is involuntary. It is involuntary, means it is not necessary to do. If government says to do, but for self-use, then institution can do it. And it can be done by the senior cost accountant of their own department and check whether any mistakes or misuse is been happen or not. Next comes external cost audit. It is done by the chartered accountant, or we can say it is done by the ICWA. If thinks that cost account is not in proper way, so we do auditing by CA or ICWA. According to their report, we take preventive measures, so it can be done by the owner or by the government. Next comes planning of cost audit. Look, planning of different cost elements is been done in this planning of cost audit. Here I have said, quoting this word, planning different cost elements. Here the element means material, labor, overhead, depreciation related kind of things is been termed as cost element. Under this, the first is audit of raw material. Controlling is there or not, valuation done in correct way or not, closing stocks valuation has been done or not, is been checked in audit of raw material. Next is audit of labor. All labors are working or not, register of labor are maintained or not, how many idle hour position is there, payment of labor position has been done or not, working hours is how much there, standard costing has been applied or not. So this kind of audit has been done in audit of labor. Next is audit of overheads. Here all the expenses are paid and recorded in a way told in the books of account, it has been done or not. And what are those expenses? Those expenses are a kind of factory overhead, office overhead, administrative overhead, selling and distribution overhead. So all overhead are related to the products or not, whether we are not including any unusual cost by the name of overheads. So it is been checked in audit of overheads. Next comes audit of stores and spare parts. What are storing facility of material? What are the storing facility of manufactured goods, factoring goods? Spare parts are related to the accounts or not? If they are not related to accounts, then whether any misuse is been done or not? Cost of production is more with their, or it is been less from the coming years or not? So these kind of things is been checked under audit of stores and spare parts. Next comes audit of work in progress. Work in progress has important role in stock. So work in progress is related to the goods, and closing stock is related to the goods. So these are in correct way or not? How much percent of work is left and how much percent of work is computed? These kind of things is been computed under audit of work in progress. So these kind of things is also audited by the auditor. Next is audit of depreciation. What is the method of depreciation? Whether the methods are not frequently changing, it should be in a uniform way. If it is changed, then what was the reason for that? What was the reason of changing the depreciation method? We all know that straight line method, diminishing method, and several methods is also been there. So there should be a correct, only one method of depreciation should be followed by any business concern. So audit of depreciation should be done. Next comes advantages of cost audit. Here the first advantage is advantage to institutions, which means what all our cost of production etc. Like, first is increase in production's capacity and efficiency, second, helpful in reducing cost of productions, and third, control over unproductive department. These are the advantages to institutions. Next is advantages to management. Management means cost related data are seen. Total cost is exceeding or not, so management can know about this about by the help of cost audit. Here total 5 points or 6 points is taken into consideration. Under this, the first is determinations of right cost. Second, control on capital erosion. Third, reliable and true data. Fourth, comparative study. Fifth, consciousness and about cost control. And sixth, at last, there is helpful in determination of personal responsibility. These are the advantages to the management by the help of doing cost audit. Next come advantages to consumers. Here there are 3 points: proper value determinations, saving to consumers, and best quality commodity. These are the advantages to consumer. Next comes advantages to government. First is possible price discriminations policy, easy to price determinations, comparative study of the cost, easy to give license, and determinations of proper profit. These are the advantages to the government which is been enjoyed by if the concern is doing cost audit. Next is helpful in improving industrial relations. Yes, labor management relationship becomes strong with the help of cost audit report, because they will give to know what profit only they will get into the business and all. Because if the labor are going to get that what amount of profit is business is procuring, and according to what amount of percentage is been which is been set to give those labor are been received by them or not is been checked. So this is helpful in improvement of industrial relationship also. Next is assistant to the financial auditor. If the cost audit are done, then the financial auditor has also done of that concern. Cost auditor work on work in progress, cost of material, stock valuations are already done by the financial auditor. So financial auditor can get some help. Okay, so it gives assistance to the financial auditor, because cost auditor has already done the audit of cost of material, stock valuation, work in progress. So these kind of things financial auditor can procure that kind of a data which has been previously done by the cost auditor itself. So it acts as an assistant to the financial auditor. Next comes provisions regarding cost audit under Companies Act 2013. Provisions regarding cost audit under Companies Act 2013. In this, it comes under section 148. In this, the first is power of central government. Here 2 points has been there. First is, you write these all points in a very correct way in your copy. I am giving you all the details. It is the gold mine details, I can must say. It is a kind of a gold mine detail. First is power of the central government. The first point is, the central government may direct to conduct cost audit in respect of companies engaged in the production of such goods or providing such services and have a net worth or turnover as may be prescribed. This is the first point. Second is, if company is regulated by any special act, the central government shall consult the regulatory body established under the such special act. This is the power of central government. Next is appointment of cost auditor. Cost auditor shall be appointed by board, whereas remuneration of cost auditor shall be determined by the members. Next comes, who can appoint the cost auditor. Cost audit shall be done by a cost accountant in practice, that is a person having certificate of practice issued by Institute of Cost Accountant of India. Next is qualification, disqualification, rights and duty of cost auditor. First point is same as that of statutory auditor. And second, it is the duty of cost auditor to comply with cost accounting standards and to submit his report to BOD it submit his report to board of director, means BOD means board of director. And cost accounting standards are the standards issued by the Institute of Cost Accountants of India. Third is, a statutory auditor of a limited company cannot be appointed as its cost auditor. These are the 3 points which comes under this sections. Next is duty of company. The first is, in the duty of company is, the board of directors shall furnish the report with central government within 30 days of the receipt of report. Second, after receiving the cost audit report, company shall also furnish full information and explanations on every reservations or qualification to central government within 30 days of receipt of cost audit report. And third, if central government requires any further information, then it is the duty of company to furnish such information within the given time. These are the duty of company which should be performed as far as the provision regarding cost audit under the Companies Act has been concerned. Next is penal provisions in case of contravention by companies. It means, if the company contravenes any of the above mentioned provisions, then company shall be punishable with a fine of ₹25,000 to ₹5 lakh, and officers of the company shall be liable for fine of ₹10,000 to ₹1 lakh, or imprisonment for a term which may extend to 1 year. It is just huge penalty. Next is penal provisions in the case of contravention by the cost auditor. Here the 2 points is there. First is, if cost auditor contravenes any of the above mentioned provision unknowingly, here I am quoting the word unknowingly, then he shall be punishable with fine of ₹25,000 to ₹5 lakh. And if he contravenes any of the above mentioned provisions knowingly, if he contravenes any of the above mentioned provisions knowingly, I am quoting this word knowingly, then he shall be punishable with fine of ₹1 lakh to ₹25 lakh, along with imprisonment for the term which may extend to 1 year. Further, he shall be liable to refund the remunerations and paid damages to the company. So these kind of things should be taken into consideration as far as the provisions, as far as the, these kind of provisions regarding cost audit under Companies Act is being concerned. Next is cost audit program. Cost audit program here, which means I am going to explain you cost audit program, that what does cost audit program is being meant of. For conducting a cost audit, the cost auditor should have a useful program. The cost audit program will concern the following principles item. What are those principal items? I'm just speaking the points. First is records of raw material and other goods. You should see the records of raw material and other goods. Second, records relating to labor, records of overhead, depreciation, work in progress. So cost audit program relating to these above items should be checked by every the cost auditor as far while making the cost audit program. So it should be well checked. So I am repeating this thing: work in progress, depreciation, recoveries of overheads, records relating to labor, and records of raw material and the other goods. So these kind of things should be taken into consideration as far as this cost audit and tax audit and management audit and a new trends in auditing is kind of a chapter which contains the 3 part: cost audit, management audit and tax audit, which I have covered in 3 videos. I'm going to post it on videos and you just read it. Is very important as far as this auditing has been concerned. So there is the end of this video, and thank you. Next video is on management audit. Do watch this video and share your views, share your doubts in the comment section. I will love to reply those. Thank you.